Welcome back. Let's talk about the transport of gases during respiration. So today in this video I will discuss about transport of oxygen. First of all, there is a distribution of oxygen in the body. If I talk about the inspired air according to partial pressure, expired air, alveolar air, arterial blood and venous blood. So this is the volume of various type of partial pressure in various form of the air, and the oxygen content here also varies. From this chart you can conclude that each 100 ml of inspired air there is a 5 ml of oxygen that is extracted by the blood. So the partial pressure is the pressure difference of the various gases. So this determines the diffusion of the gases across the respiratory membrane, that is across the capillary wall and the alveolar wall. Next is the carriage of the oxygen in the blood. So oxygen is carried in the blood in two form. First is the dissolved form and second is the combined with the hemoglobin. The major distribution is by the hemoglobin. 0.3 ml of the 100 ml blood is dissolved oxygen, and it increases with increase the partial pressure of the arterial blood. More the oxygenated blood, more we dissolved oxygen in the blood. If I talk about the hemoglobin, it is a tetraheme group having the center Fe2 ferrous ion, and one Fe2 metal ion can combine with one oxygen molecule. And here are the four Fe in the four heme. So there are eight atom can combine with the heme, four heme group or the four molecule. So oxygen carrying power of hemoglobin is given by oxygen dissociation curve, that is hemoglobin dissociation curve. It generate or determine the percentage of saturation of hemoglobin with partial pressure of oxygen, and it is sigmoid in nature. I will talk about later about it. Next, there is the oxygenation of hemoglobin. Before oxygenation it is purple color, by combining with oxygen it become bright red in color. So oxygenation occur by increasing partial pressure of oxygen in the lungs, alveoli. With a low pressure it become backward reaction. So here it can combine with four oxygen molecule. Why it is sigmoid? Due to the shifting affinity of hemoglobin for oxygen. So hemoglobin molecule have two form of globin. First is the T form, that is tension form. Second is the R or lax form. T form is the deoxyhemoglobin. The globin protein is tightly bound and it is less affinity for the oxygen. But if I talk about the R form, it has a release holding which hemoglobin unit, and it is a relaxed form and it increases the saturation of hemoglobin with the oxygen. But the saturation of the heme four atom of the Fe2 do not occur simultaneously and immediately. It occur in steps. First combination of heme molecule with oxygen increases its affinity for the next oxygen and so on. So it occurs step by step, as you can see from this reaction. So the shifting affinity of hemoglobin for oxygen due to TR interconversion give the sigmoid shape to the oxygen dissociation curve. If we increase the concentration of salt and electrolyte, what happen if we increase concentration of salt and electrolyte in blood? So curve become more and more sigmoid due to salt. At the maximum partial pressure of oxygen, here is 120 ml of 120 ml hemoglobin gets saturated. Full capacity, the 1 gram of hemoglobin has 1.34 ml of oxygen. So in a normal person there is a 50 mg of the hemoglobin. So if we multiply 1.34 into 15, so it comes the 20 ml. So the hemoglobin can transport 20 ml oxygen it can carry. This is the actual sigmoid curve of oxygen dissociation. So from 0 to it become firstly steep, then it become curved, steep and flat part. So it is the sigmoid shape of oxygen dissociation curve. So full saturation here occur. So it is the percentage of oxygen saturated in the hemoglobin, and it is the partial pressure of oxygen. So oxygen dissociation curve at partial pressure 40 mm of the mercury. So here the pH is 7.4 and temperature 37 degree centigrade. Next is the factor affecting the hemoglobin dissociation curve. First is the shift to right. That is, at any partial pressure, the oxygen content that can be held by blood decreases, causing the unloading of oxygen. So if another gas is occurring in the blood, so it will be dissociated from the hemoglobin and it will be decreased in the hemoglobin. Causes: fall in the blood pH due to the increased CO2. So CO2 is the acidic nature, increases acidity. Presence of any acid in the blood increases the body temperature. When body temperature increases, the also increase in concentration 2,3-diphosphoglycerolic acid at 2,3-DPG. It is a byproduct of the glycolysis and it is plentiful in the RBC. So it is highly charged anion and it produces the acidity, and it bind with the beta chain of the deoxyhemoglobin and compete with oxygen binding with the hemoglobin. So hemoglobin molecule are dissociated and with oxygen, and at any given partial pressure, the saturation of percentage of hemoglobin with oxygen will be reduced in the presence of 2,3-DPG. So if the DPG level increases, the hemoglobin will be deoxygenated. Next very important phenomena here become the Bohr effect in the transport of oxygen, that is the decrease in O2 affinity of hemoglobin with change in the pH of the blood fall. And we can say this is the Bohr effect, that is the loading of CO2 and unloading of oxygen, and this is seen at the tissue level. What is the shift to the left? Affinity of hemoglobin to combine with oxygen increases, causing the less release of oxygen to the tissue. And when it is more bound, it become shift to left. When it is dissociated from, it shift to the right. So it has the causes: carbon monoxide, fetal hemoglobin, myoglobin, and decrease in body temperature. CO have the more 210 times more affinity to hemoglobin than the oxygen. So it become more tightly bound. Fetal hemoglobin had also more affinity and with the 2,3-DGP. So in the fetal, it is more affinity than the adult hemoglobin. So the fetal hemoglobin shift the curve to the left. That is, a lower partial pressure is required to bind a given amount of oxygen. So if these products are available, the more and more oxygen will bind with the hemoglobin. So hence, as you also know, the fetal's children have the low metabolic rate and they don't need to face with the hypoxia. So this avoid the hypoxia condition due to the hemoglobin F. Next is the myoglobin. So it is an iron containing pigment found in the muscles. So it is normally called the storage of the oxygen. So it has only one hemoglobin and with one polypeptide chain. So here 1/4 molecule weight of hemoglobin. So it is less potent for oxygen binding. It take up oxygen at low pressure much more readily than does the blood. That is, the rate of association of myoglobin with oxygen is very fast. So its dissociation curve is a rectangular hyperbola rather than the sigmoid due to this fast affinity. It does not show Bohr effect. That is, as a result, even at the partial pressure of 40 mm of mercury, it is 95% saturated. So its dissociation don't follow the trend as that of the hemoglobin. So it don't show the Bohr effect. And this is the difference between the hemoglobin and myoglobin dissociation. So here you can see shifting to left and right. When it is shifting to the left, it means it is more dissociated and it is readily available in the cell. If it is shifting to the right, it is tightly bound with hemoglobin. So it's the association that is shifting to the left, mean the Bohr effect, and shifting to the R, mean the Holden effect, you can also see. So it is for the myoglobin, you can see. So myoglobin affinity, here is the major difference. Temperature here, partial pressure is given, pH is given. So affinity, the shifting to left and right is considerable different in these cases. So you can see myoglobin shift more to left and hemoglobin less to the left due to the difference of their composition structure. Next are the vehicle for transport of oxygen: plasma, hemoglobin solution and blood. So here the main is the blood. So blood play more role for the transport of the oxygen. So it is called the ideal vehicle. So in the blood, if the partial pressure of oxygen decreases below the 40 mm of mercury, the curve become the steep and oxygen is readily made available to the tissue. The difference between the behavior of simple solution of the hemoglobin and the whole blood in the body is explained by the fact that the blood is at a temperature 37 degree, partial pressure 40 mm of mercury, contain a high concentration of the hemoglobin of the RBC, so maximum saturation of hemoglobin. So hemoglobin more available in the blood. Also the 5 ml of oxygen is given of a rest when the PO2 of the venous blood is 40 mm of mercury. So 13 ml of oxygen is given off during the moderate activity when PO2 of venous is 25 mm of mercury. So that availability of the oxygen in the blood differ and it compensates the requirement. So the blood is an ideal vehicle for the transport of oxygen, to load itself in lung with oxygen and to unload oxygen in the tissue. Also this is in the plasma, you can see the concentration of oxygen and it is the pressure. You can see it is 0.18 mm per deciliter of the blood. It is for the hemoglobin, it is 1.5 ml, and it is for the blood, it is 5 ml per deciliter of blood. So you can here conclude the best vehicle here is the blood for the transport of oxygen. Thank you very much for watching this video. I hope you have well understood the transport of oxygen in various vehicle involved, role of the hemoglobin, myoglobin and Bohr effect. If you like this video, subscribe my channel and share this video among the science student. Thank you very much. Stay tuned my channel for the more and more beautiful, helpful video for you. Thank you very much.